Good morning to all the students. Yesterday we have started the concept of stacks, where we have defined what a stack is and what are the valid operations or the basic operations that can be performed on stack. And then we have gone through some of the applications of stacks, the real life examples and the applications of stacks in the computer science world also. So in today's session we'll discuss one of the application of the stack, which is nested parenthesis check. That means we are going to check whether the parenthesis in the given expression is valid or invalid. So there are two conditions to check for whether the expression has the correct parenthesis, balanced parenthesis or not. We'll see those two conditions, and if the two conditions are satisfied by an expression, then we say that the expression is consisting of the balanced parenthesis. Otherwise, we have to throw an error. Right. So there exists an algorithm. So how do you check whether the parenthesis in an expression is balanced or not? So we will make use of the data structure called stack to identify whether an expression consists of balanced parenthesis or not. Right. So we'll see an algorithm, very simple algorithm, and after this we'll go to one more important topic, which is the types of expression. Right. We'll see what an expression is, and we'll see what are the types of expressions we have. And then we'll convert one form of expression into another form of expression manually, which is useful for you to process the expression or to convert the expression in a faster fashion. Right. And then we'll go through the algorithmic part, how we make use of the stack to convert the infix expression to postfix. So this is what we have in our syllabus. Conversion of infix to postfix using stack. But other than this, we also have some videos that are that show how we can convert other forms of the expression into some other form. That means, how do you convert a prefix expression to a postfix? How do you convert a postfix to infix? All these videos are there. So by this end of the session, you will come to know what how a stack can be used to check the balanced parenthesis in a given expression. And similarly, we'll also see how the stacks can be used to convert the infix expression into postfix expression. Right. So let us go into the discussion. Yesterday I told you, right, that we have a three categories of parentheses. So if you see here, here is the curly braces, or we can make use of the square brackets, or we can make use of the parentheses. So these three types of braces can be used in our expression. So we know what nested means. Nesting means it is nothing but putting one thing inside another thing is called as nesting. So what do you mean by nested parentheses? Means one parenthesis inside another parenthesis. That means they can be of different kind also. For example, if I have three parentheses like this, so this is one kind of nested parenthesis. Or else I can give like this, this is also one kind of nested parenthesis. So these are all the different kinds of parentheses we can make use of them in the expression. Now, as I told that the data structure that is used to check whether the parenthesis is balanced or not is the stack. So we make use of the stack data structure to check whether the symbols are balanced or not. Right. So there are two conditions. In the earlier in the class, in this session, I told that there are two conditions to be checked whether the mathematical expression is correctly formed with the parenthesis or not. Or else we can also say like this, whether the mathematical expression has the balanced parentheses. It has the equal set of parentheses on it. Here is the first condition where we have to check whether the left and right parentheses are equal in number or not. So there should be equal number of right and left parentheses. If this condition is satisfied, we say that the expression is having a balanced parenthesis. Similarly, there is another condition, this one. So every right parenthesis is preceded by a matching left parenthesis. What do you mean by right parenthesis? So if you take the curly brace, this is the right curly brace, and this is the right square bracket, and this is the right parenthesis. In the second point, what he is saying is every right parenthesis should be preceded. Preceded means before processing this right parenthesis, it should have, we must have processed the left corresponding, matching means corresponding, right? You should process the matching left parenthesis. So for this right parenthesis, we have this left parenthesis. For this right square bracket, we have the matching left square bracket. And for this right curly braces, we have the matching left curly. So if these two conditions are satisfied, then only we say that the expression that we have is having the correct or balanced parenthesis. Right. So what is that condition? First one is the on the number of parentheses. So it should have equal number of right and left parentheses. And the second condition is every right parenthesis should be preceded with the matching. Matching is important. So it should be preceded by a corresponding left parenthesis. So we should follow these two conditions. We'll see with an example. Don't worry. For example, if we have this expression, let us take this expression. We are not going to deal with these two expressions by using the algorithm. In the next slide, we will go through the algorithm and then we'll check whether these expressions are correct or not. So if you look at the expression manually, how many left parentheses are there? Two. How many right parentheses are there? Only one. Okay. So what condition it is violating? It is violating condition one, which says that there should be equal number of right and left parentheses. Similarly, if you take this second expression, so the first symbol that we are going to process is the right parenthesis. But what he told in the second condition, the author is saying that every right parenthesis should be preceded by a matching left parenthesis. Therefore, this right parenthesis which we have processed at this point does not consist of any left parenthesis. Therefore, it violates condition two. So since these two expressions are violating the condition one and condition two, we say are not balanced, or we say that these expressions does not have the balanced parenthesis. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
So this is the algorithm for balanced symbol checking. Symbol is nothing but parenthesis. Don't confuse by this term symbol. Symbol is nothing but parenthesis. So we are going to make use of the stack to check whether the parentheses are balanced or not. Right? So what is step one here? What is step one?
Make an empty stack.
You have to make an empty stack. That is nothing but you have to declare an array. That's it. So how do you implement stack? What are the two ways of implementing the stack?
Using arrays and linked list,
right? So we are going to deal this particular concept using arrays. So whenever he is saying that make an empty stack, that means you should declare an array of some particular size. So this is a very simple step, and going to step two. So whatever expression is given to you, for example, I have an expression like this, a plus b minus c. Suppose we have an expression like this. You have to read the symbols from the left hand side towards the right hand side until you reach the end of the file. Right? So one symbol you read and then you process these steps. And after completing processing these steps, we again read the next symbol. Then next symbol. Like that, you have to process the given expression or you have to parse the given expression from the left hand side to right hand. Right? You have to read each and every symbol. We call them as tokens. When you read one symbol from the given expression, we can call it as a token. So this is one token, this is another token, and this is A is another token, plus is another token. Like that, we have number of tokens. Right. So what about the next step? It is, let us take it as 2.A or 2.1. Let us take it. So if the symbol is an opening symbol, just push it onto the step. Very simple step. Right. So whenever you come across, whenever the token that is red is the left parenthesis, right? Opening symbol is nothing but left symbol. Closing symbol means right parenthesis. Right? So whenever you come across a token which is a opening symbol, or else you can call it as the left parenthesis, the thing you have to do is, the task is just to push it onto the stack, right? And then coming to 2.2, what it is saying, it is 2.2 is going to deal with the closing symbol. Closing symbol is nothing but the closed parenthesis, right? So if you come across a token which is a closing symbol, you have to do the following steps. What is that? 2.2.1, what does 2.2.1 is saying here? These two steps are very, very important, right? So if the stack is empty, report an error. So whenever you come across a closing parenthesis and you find whether the stack is empty or not. So if the stack is empty, then you report an error. As I told that, the algorithm for balanced symbol checking or parenthesis checking is going to tell you whether the given expression is balanced. If the given expression is not balanced, then you have to report an error. You have to say that there is an error, right? So whenever you come across a closing symbol, you go and check the stack. If the stack is empty, then you have to report an error. For example, we'll see it in example later, right? And similarly, 2.2.2, what it is saying, if the closing symbol, whenever you come across the closing symbol, and if you find that the stack is not empty, listen carefully, if the stack is empty, then you just report an error. If the stack is not empty, you have to pop the stack. Pop means, what does a pop operation do?
Deletes.
So it deletes, you have to tell it correctly, right? The correct statement is, deleting an element from the top of the stack is called as pop operation. So whenever you check the stack and you find that the stack is not empty, then you pop the stack. That means you take the top element from the stack. So if the symbol pop does not match the closing symbol, then you report an error. Right. So whatever symbol you pop, you check whether it is the correct matching symbol with the closing symbol or not. So if they are matching, then just remove it, then pop it. That's it. But if they are not matching, then we have to report an error. Right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So once you reach the end of the file, that means once you reach the end of the expression, and then again you found that the stack is not empty. Right. Whenever you reach the end of the expression and you find that the stack is not empty, then only you have to report that there is an error. Right. We'll see all these conditions with examples. Is it clear? The first step is you have to create an empty stack. The second step is you have to read symbols one by one from the given expression, and we call them as tokens. And if the symbol is an opening symbol, what is that you have to do? You just push it onto the stack. But if the symbol is a closing symbol, then you have to check whether the stack is empty or not. If the stack is empty, then you have to report another. If the stack is not empty, then you have to pop the stack and you have to check whether the popped element matches with the closing parenthesis or not. If they both are matching, then there is no problem. If they are not matching, then you have to report an error. After you reach the end of the expression, that means one by one symbol you are reading, and when you reach the end of the statement, if the stack is not empty, then you have to report an error. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now let us take an example and then try with that example. Just give me 1 minute after. Let us try this with an example. What is the first step? You have to create a stack like this. Are you able to see the Word document?
Yes, sir.
So let us take a stack which is of size 4. And the push and pop operations you know very well, right? So what you have to do after this initializing the stack, you have to read the given expression from the left hand side. So you read the first symbol. What is the first symbol?
Open parenthesis.
That means it is a opening symbol. So what you have to do when you come across the opening symbol, nothing to do, you just push it onto the stack. So push the element onto the stack. Next, go and increment the pointer such that the pointer is pointing to the next token. What is the next token?
Open square bracket.
What is that you have to do? Whenever you find a opening symbol, you just push it onto the stack, right? And then nothing to do with the operands and operators. Here A and B are operands and plus is an operator. The algorithm is going to check whether the balanced parenthesis is there or not. That's it. So nothing to do with the operands and operators. Whenever you have the parenthesis, then only it is going to operate. So you increment the pointer and such that it is pointing to A. Since it is operand, nothing to do, just increment, and then you make the pointer to point to plus. Since it is an operator, nothing to do, leave it, go to the next one. And it is an operand, nothing to do, leave it, go to the next one. And the next symbol you are going to read is, what is
close
the symbol?
Closed square bracket.
So whenever you come across the closed square bracket, then you have to be careful. So whenever you come across a closing parenthesis, what is that you have to do? You have to check whether the stack is empty or not. Here in this situation, is the stack empty or does it contain any symbol?
Contains symbols.
Now you tell me where the top is pointing to. Top is pointing to this location, right? So now you pop the stack. If the stack is not empty, you have to pop the stack. So what is that element you have popped?
Opening square bracket.
Right. And does it match with the symbol that is being taken as the token? Are these matching or not?
Yes,
they're matching. Now, after popping, where the top is pointing? The top is pointing to this location. Is it right or not?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, when you come again back to this expression, you have reached the end of the expression. But when you look at the stack, so once you reach the end of the expression, the stack should be empty. Right? Once you reach the end of the expression, here the stack is not empty. In such situation, what you have to do? You have to report
an error.
Error means nothing but the expression that you have taken is not consisting of balanced parentheses. That is what you have to print. Is it right or not? So at what condition this is breaking? If you go to the algorithm, where it is violating, at what step? Is it at 2.1?
It is step 3, sir.
Right, it is at step 3. So the condition is violating at step 3. Let us take one more example. So coming back to this example, the same thing which we have taken earlier, right? So whenever you come across a closing parenthesis, you take an empty stack, push it, and then another symbol you have read is again the opening parenthesis, push it, forget about this operands and operators, and when you come across the closing parenthesis, you have to check whether the stack is empty or not. Here the stack is not empty, therefore you pop the element, and the top element that is popped is close opening parenthesis. And you have to check whether the both symbols are matching or not. Yes, they are matching. And then you have reached the end of the expression. But still you are having elements in the stack which is violating. Right. Therefore, you have to report an error. Now tell me. Let us take this example. As the first step, you have to initialize the stack, and you start reading the expression from the left hand side. What is the first token you have taken?
Closed parenthesis.
So whenever you come across the closed parenthesis, what you have to do? You have to check whether the stack is empty or not. If the stack is empty, you just have to report an error. So what is the condition it is violating? At what step this particular expression is violating? Is it at 2.2?
2.2, sir.
Yeah. It's 2.2 or 2.2.1?
2.2.1, sir.
Yes, right. So this particular expression is violating the balanced parenthesis check at step 2.2.1. So when you come across a closed parenthesis, you have to check whether the stack is empty or not. You have to check whether the stack is empty or not. If the stack is empty, you just have to raise an error. Right. So at this 2.2.1, the condition is violated. Now let us go with the last one, last example. Right, this one. Are you able to see this one?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Again, initialize a stack. Initialize a stack and you start reading the symbols from the left hand side. What is the first symbol you have come across?
Open square bracket.
Open square bracket. When you come across a opening symbol, what you have to do?
Push then.
Push it, right. So you push it onto the stack. Next, you increment the pointer and let us increment the pointer, and the pointer is pointing to this symbol. Since it is a opening parenthesis, what you have to do? Again, you have to push it onto the stack. Now forget about these operators and operands. What is that you have come across here?
Closed square.
So when you come across a closed symbol, you have to
check whether stack is empty or not.
Yes, the stack is not empty in this condition, right? So you have to pop the element, pop the stack. That means the top element is popped, and you have to check whether this symbol, the popped element, is matched with that token or not? Are they matching or not?
No, sir.
No,
no, they are not matching. So it is violating the condition. Right. At what condition it is violating?
2.2.2.2.
Tell me at what condition it is violating?
2.2.2.
So this is how you have to check whether the given expression is having the balanced parenthesis or not. Is it clear? Very simple algorithm, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, this particular topic is completed. That means checking of balanced parenthesis is completed, and we have done it with an algorithm. We have seen three examples and we have evaluated, not illustrated, we have illustrated the algorithm with the examples. Now we are entering into one more important topic. This is very, very important. Please concentrate. One more important topic where we are going to discuss what is an expression, what are the various types of expressions, and how do we convert one form of expression into another form. As I told that we will be doing it manually, and then we will be dealing with the converting the one form of expression into another form of expression using stacks also, right? Using stacks is very important. Manual process of converting one form of expression into another form is just an optional thing we are giving you, right? So can anybody tell me what is an expression? What is an expression?
Combination of both components and operations.
Super, right. So an expression is nothing but a sequence of operands and operators. We can call it as a sequence, or we can say it as the combination of operands and operators. Nothing wrong in it, right? So we have operands like which are represented in this alphabets, like lowercase alphabets like a to small z, and we can also represent them with uppercase letters a to z, and we can also make use of these alphabets also, or numbers, digits, right? 0 to 9, we can make use of anything for an operand. Nothing wrong in it, right? And what are the various operators we have in C programming language? We have seen different categories of operators like arithmetic, logical, relational, bitwise, assignment, like that. We have many number of operators, right? But we'll be dealing, whenever we are considering the expression evaluation, so we'll be dealing only with the arithmetic operators only. So what are the arithmetic operators we have? Addition we have, subtraction we have, multiplication, division, and one more expression or one more operator we are going to consider in this type of expression evaluation is cap symbol, which is nothing but the exponentiation. What is that one? Exponentiation, the power, right? So in general, what is the format we are going to use? We will write the expressions in such a way that we will include the operator in between the operands. You people know the difference between the unary operator, binary and ternary, right? What do you mean by a binary operator?
Two operands,
which involves
two operands.
So an operator, if it involves two operands, then it is called as a binary operator. So in this case, or in these examples, we are going to deal with the binary operators only. And so if I want to write an expression of adding two digits or two alphabets, I can write it as A plus B. Is it correct or not? So I am including the operator in between the operands. So A and B are operands, and my operator is plus. Therefore, I am including the plus operator in between the operands A and B. So these type of expressions are called as infix expressions. Infix. But there is another form where we can make use of. There are two other forms. There are two other forms of expressions we can make use of. It, right. Those are, if we place the operator before the operands. What are the operands I have here? A and P, right? So if I place the operator before the operands, then these type of expressions are called as prefix expressions. Prefix, right? What do you mean by pre? Before. So when you fix the operators before the operands, then those type of expressions are called as prefix expressions. And we have one more expression, category of expression, where I am writing the operator after the operands. So when we come across after, we call them as post. So these type of expressions are called as postfix expressions. Right. So we have three categories of expressions. One is the infix expression, and the second one is the prefix expression, and the third one is the postfix expression. So how we are going to categorize these expressions? We are going to categorize these expressions by the location of the operator. So by looking at the location of the operator, we categorize the expressions into three categories. If the operator is placed in between the operands, we call it as infix expression. If the operator is placed before the operands, we call it as prefix expression. And if the operator is placed after the operands, we call it as postfix expression. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Right. Sir, why do we need all these expressions, sir? We know that we are very well accustomed to this infix expression. So if I want to write an expression like this, A plus B star C, we are very much accustomed for this type of expression. That means the humans can easily understand the infix expression. But the problem with these infix expressions is, if I want to separate the things, so this is another expression, A plus B star A minus C. So I am putting the brackets, or I am putting the parentheses for the sub expression A plus B. Similarly, I am putting the parentheses for the sub expression A minus C. And then I am multiplying these two sub expressions like this. But the problem with the computers is they find difficulty in evaluating the expressions which consists of parentheses. Right. As a human being, we are very much interested to do this, we are very much interested in this form of expressions where it consists of parentheses. Parentheses means it includes the priority. So whenever you want to give highest priority to a sub expression, then you put it inside the parentheses. Then we can say that sub expression is having the highest priority. Right. But the computers find difficulty in evaluating the expressions which consists of parentheses. That is the reason why when you give an infix expression to the computer, it will automatically convert the infix expression to the postfix expression. And then it will evaluate the postfix expression. Right. We'll see this conversion of infix to postfix is one of the stack application. Similarly, the evaluation of the postfix expression is another stack application. That is why we are going to study both these algorithms using stacks. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So how many categories of expressions are there?
Three categories.
Three.
What are those?
prefix and postfix.
And what basis the categories are divided?
Based on the position of the operator.
So an expression is nothing but a series of operators and operands. This is what we have discussed. And operators, we will take the operators as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modular division, and I have given the exponentiation symbol as cap symbol. We can make use of the cap symbol as well as some textbook, they make use of the dollar symbol also. Dollar should be considered as the exponentiation. And coming to the operands, the values that we are going into, that are going to be operated, are called as operands. In general, we represent it with the alphabets in the lower case, or alphabets in the upper case, or we can make use of the digits from 0 to 9 also. So there are three representations of an expression, that is infix expression, and prefix expression, and the third one is the postfix. We know the difference between these three representations, right? Now let us take a few examples and try to convert them from the infix to prefix. Right. This we are not to deal with the stack. In today's class, we will do it manually, and then in tomorrow's class, we will again solve this infix conversion, infix to prefix and infix to postfix conversion using stack. So these are all the infix expressions that are given to me. What is the first one? It is A plus B. So if I want to convert it into prefix expression, what you have to do? I have to place this operator before the operands. That's it. Nothing more than that. So what are the two operands I have?
A and B, sir.
A and B, right. What is the left operand?
A, sir.
A. What is the right operand?
B, sir.
B. So you have to place the left operand first and then the right operand later. You should not change this order. The left operand should always be in the first position and the right operand should always be in the next position. Right. So after writing the left operand and right operand, you place the operator before this operand. So plus AB is the corresponding prefix expression for the A plus B. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So next we'll go with the second example, which is A plus B minus C. Right. So when we have an expression that consists of different operators, how many operators are there here? Two, plus and minus. Right. When we come across the different operators in a given expression, then you have to check the priority of the operators. Precedence. Have you ever heard of the term precedence in C programming language?
Yes, sir.
What does the precedence specify?
Which operation should be done first?
So precedence specify the priority of the operator. So when we come across these two operators in the second expression, this one, how many operators are there? Plus and minus are there. What is the priority of plus and minus? Are they equal, or any of the operator is having the highest priority than the other operator? So while coming to the precedence, let us draw the table once again. The dollar symbol, what is dollar symbol indicates?
Exponentiation.
This is having the highest priority. And in the second category, we come across the operands multiplication, division, and modular division.
Right.
So the second prioritized operators are multiplication, division. This is not minus, sorry. division and modular division occupies the second position, and in the last position we have the plus and minus. Right. So the plus and minus are having the equal priority. So while discussing the concept of precedence of the operators, we have come across another term called as associativity. What do you mean by associativity? Anybody please tell me, what do you mean by associativity?
Now we have to go from left to right while discussing these operators.
Yeah. So when we come across a situation where we have different operators and some of the operators are having the equal precedence, then we have to go for the concept of associativity. And associativity is of two types. One is left to right, and second one is right to left. As we have seen in the C programming language, that almost 80 to 90% of the operators are left to right only, except for very few operators like the unary operators and assignment operators. Like that, they have the associativity right to left, right? Otherwise, all the operators, maximum operators, are having the left to right associativity. So what do you mean by left to right associativity? The left to right associativity says that you have to pass the given expression from the left hand side, and whatever operator that comes first, that operator should be evaluated first. And similarly, what do you mean by right to left?
Right operator should be given first priority.
Yeah, you have to parse the given expression from the right hand side, and whatever operator comes first from the right hand side, that operator should be evaluated first before going to the other operator. Right. So in the second expression, that is a plus b minus c, I have two operators, that is plus and minus. And I came to know that the precedence of these two operators are equal. Therefore, I have to go to the concept of associativity. According to the associativity of plus and minus, both of them are having the left to right associativity. So you pass the given expression from the left hand side. So what is the operator that you come across first one?
Plus.
Plus. Therefore, plus has to be evaluated first rather than minus, right? So you first evaluate plus. Evaluation is nothing but convert this sub expression a plus b into the prefix expression, right? So if I convert the sub expression a plus b to the prefix, what is that I get?
Plus ab.
Plus ab. And what is the operator I have left with? Minus. And what is the operand I have? C. Now look at the point here. After converting the infix expression to the prefix expression or postfix expression, you have to consider the entire sub expression, entire prefix expression or entire postfix expression as an operand, as a single operand. Right. Now tell me, minus is an operator, right? I have only one operator left with me, minus. And what are the operands I have that are operating on minus?
Plus A, B, and C.
So C is one operand, that is operand 2, that is right operand, and plus A, B, entire plus A, B has to be taken as one operand, that is operand 1, and C becomes operand 2. So while after converting this sub expression into the prefix expression, what is that I have to write? First, I have to write the operand 1, which is plus A, B, and I have to write the operand 2, which is C. And then you have to write the operator minus before these two operands. So this is operand 1 and this operand 2, and before that I place the operator. So minus plus ABC is the corresponding prefix expression for the infix expression A plus B minus. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Let us take one more example. A plus B star C. You tell me this example. So how many operators are there?
3
ऑपरेटर्स है ना
2 सर
2 सर 2 सर
ऑपरेटर प्लस एंड स्टार ऑपरेंड्स मींस 3 ए बी एंड सी राइट नाउ यू हैव कम अक्रॉस ए सिचुएशन वेयर यू हैव टू ऑपरेटर्स नाउ यू हैव टू गो फॉर द प्रेसिडेंस ऑफ द ऑपरेटर आउट ऑफ प्लस एंड स्टार व्हिच इज हैविंग द हाईएस्ट प्रेसिडेंस
स्टार
स्टार देयरफॉर Is there any necessity to go for the associativity concept?
No, sir.
No, associativity comes into existence whenever you come across a situation where the operators are having the equal precedence. Here, in this situation, star is having the highest precedence than plus. Therefore, you have to evaluate this sub-expression first. So, after converting the sub-expression, what I will get? I have to write A as it is. And I have to convert this D star C into prefix, right? So you have to write the remaining expression as it is. So it becomes A plus. Now you convert this D star C into prefix. What happens?
Star B C.
Star B C. Remember carefully that one important point is you have to consider this star B C as an operand, as a single operand. So in order to avoid confusion, what you have to do is you take a pencil and you mark a line over this operand so that you can identify it that star bc is a single operand right since this is a simple expression you won't get any confusion at this point but when you go to the other expressions which are complex expressions then it is mandatory or it is very good practice that you always give a over line over this operand to identify it as a single operand Now, how many operators I am left with here?
One.
Super. What are the operands that is being operated by plus?
A and star BC.
A is one operand and star BC is another operand. So, if I write the prefix expression, I have to write the operand one A and the second operand star BC and plus should be prefixed before this. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now let us take another example. What is that I will get here? A by B star C. So I have two operators, division and star. Both of them are having the equal precedence. Therefore, you have to go for the associativity. According to the associativity, division and star are having the equal precedence. Therefore. According to the associativity, division and star are the left to right associative operators. Therefore, you start passing the given expression from the left hand side. What is the symbol I got here? First symbol.
Division.
So I have to simplify that division sub expression. So again, you have to convert this one. So it becomes A B C star division A B. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Let us go with the third example. A plus B star C minus D. Now, if you consider how many operators are there in this expression?
3, sir.
3 plus star and minus right but other than these operators we have the parenthesis so when you have parenthesis first what you have to do is you have to simplify the parenthesis expressions first whether you simplify the left parenthesis or right parenthesis that is up to you and the result will be same whether you simplify the left parenthesis first and then you go for the right parenthesis or you go from the right parenthesis to left parenthesis Anything you will get the same answer only. But since we are following the concept or a rule, it's not a rule, a convention. We are following the convention of left to right. Make it a practice that you simplify the left parenthesis first, and then you go for the right parenthesis. Nothing wrong in it, right? So whenever we have the parenthesis, you should be very careful that you have to first simplify the expression that are present inside the parenthesis. So what is that I have to do here? So and one more important thing you have to remember is forget about the operators, right? Even though the star is having the highest priority than plus and minus, and since star has to be evaluated first, if it does not consist of these parentheses, then you have to follow that rule. But if you have the parentheses, what is that you have to follow? You make it sure that the parentheses, the sub expressions inside the parentheses are evaluated first, right? So what is that I have to simplify first?
A plus b,
right? So I convert it, and remember one more important point. This is very important point. Whenever you are writing the infix expressions and the postfix expressions, never ever include the parentheses. As I told that there are three types of expressions. One is infix, prefix, and postfix. Though as humans we are familiar with the infix expressions, which consists of parentheses, computers, they make use of either the infix or postfix. Why? Because these expressions in prefix and postfix, they does not have parentheses. So be careful that when you write the prefix or postfix expression, you never include the parentheses. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
So after simplifying the left parenthesis, it is a plus ab. So in order to identify this plus ab as an operand, I told you to give a over line over this, right? And you write the remaining expression as it is. Now what is that I have to simplify after this step?
C minus b.
Super. How many operators are left with me?
Two,
star and minus. But don't go for the priority. Why? Because I have the parentheses. I should first evaluate the parentheses. So it becomes plus AB and star. What does it be? What about the next step?
Minus CD.
And you remember that minus CD has to be given over line. Now how many operators are there?
Only one operator.
Right. What are the operands? Plus AB is the first operand.
Minus
CD is the second operand. And you write the
star.
Operator star. So the corresponding prefix expression for the given infix expression is star plus AB minus CD. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. What is the next class?
Max.
So let us stop our discussion at this point, and this is the end of today's session. And in tomorrow's class, we'll again continue with the same concept of converting the infix to prefix, and then we'll go to the conversion of infix to postfix. At max, we'll try to convert. We'll try to complete the concept of converting the infix to postfix expression using stacks. Very, very important algorithm and very important according to your examination point of view. Right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
You can leave. Thank you, one and all. You can leave. This is end of today's session.
Thank you, sir.